Now we will discuss the dynamic programming with the use of a simple example known as Manhattan tourism problem. So this is a Manhattan is a place in New York with tourist attractions. So we will use this problem, and the tourists in this problem have to see the maximum number of attractions by using a certain directions. And after using this Manhattan tourism problem, we will use this for computing the DNA sequencing alignment problem. And we will use this computation as a dynamic problem for the DNA alignment. So here we can see that there are the sightseeings in the Manhattan area, and we can see that there are different numbers here, and these designating the different areas present in the Manhattan, that is the tourist resort area. So we can see here number 5 is seasons, Four Seasons, and here is the 5 Four Seasons. Similarly, it's the Times Square number 12, so we can see it's number 12 and Times Square. So different areas, 15 areas and 15 numbers here. So a tourist has to start from, if we assume that this is the north, this is the south, this is east, and this is a west. So tourist has to start from the corner of 59th Street and 8th Avenue. And it has to go to the end of this one, 15. And this is the 42nd Street and Lexington Avenue. So starting from here, it has to move in different directions and end up here. So there are many attractions along the way. But assume for the moment that the tourists want to see as many attractions as possible. The tourists are allowed to move either in the south. So this is south. They can move either in this direction or in the east in this direction. So these are the two directions the tourists can move starting from this point. So it cannot move in the north or in the west direction. We can see here there are two paths mentioning here. The first path is the upper path starting from here, and it goes down up to here. So this is the first path tourist is using. So if we use this path, we can see here the tourist will visit the Museum of Modern Arts at number 4. But if we use this path, the tourist will miss the Times Square, that is at number 12, because it will move in this direction. So there is another path here, this one. So if the tourist use this path, so it can see the Times Square, but it will miss the Museum of Modern Arts. So we can see here that this map can also be represented in the grid form. We can see here this is the grid graph representing the same tourist problem, and we can see here the number that is written on the lines, for example this 2, 3, any number, it is called as a weight, showing the number of attractions in every block. It means that if it is 3, 1, 3, it means that there are 7 attractions in this area. And if we assume this block, there are 4, 5, 3, 2. So it means that if we calculate this, it means that this is the total number of attractions, means the different buildings and sightseeing in this block. So it represented as weight. So the tourists must decide among the most possible paths between the northeast most point. So we can again mark it north, south, east and west. So tourist has to start from the extreme north west point. So this is the northwest point, and it has to end up, and this point is called the source vertex. So this is the point from where the tourist will start. It's a sore vertex. And the southeast, this is the point which is the most southeast point, and it is called the sink vertex. So it has to start from here to here. So weight of the path from the source to the sink is simply the sum of weights on its edges or the overall number of attractions. So the path it will consider, for example, it moves here, so we will consider 3, and it moves further, we will add 2 in it, and it moves here, we add 2, 3, 2, 6 and 7. So we have to calculate the numbers of attraction on this path, and when it end up at this point, we will calculate all the numbers on the edges. So we assume that the horizontal edge of the graph are oriented in the east and this is in the south direction. And the streets, it means that we call these arrows as street and these are called vertices. And the edges means this one is called the edge. So a path is a continuation of the, in this direction is called a path, and maximum path is the path which has the maximum number of score. So we can see here in, again in the Manhattan problem, that the upper half of this map, this upper half has more attraction as compared to the lower half. But it is not clear if there is any even better path in the grid. The Manhattan tourist problem is to find the path with the maximum number of attractions. That is the longest path in the grid. Here we can see this is the path adopted by the tourist starting from the source point, and it moves in the east direction and it moves here. This is the 3, we added 3, and further move we add 2 becomes 5, 5 plus 4 becomes 9, 9 plus 4 13, 2 15, 4 19, 20 and 3 23. So if the tourists adopt this path, so the total number that this path has 23. So it could be the maximum number one attraction one tourist can see while using this path. So by using the dynamic problem, we can find the best solutions of this problem.